anything for who I am now and for all that I have achieved. Manipulation of their drug
In 2016, the president identified that no names were given, but they did say that it included 12 competitors who had won medals, so it should be fairly straightforward for people to work that one out. Although, why is it even named, and it never does when it's carrying out attempting investigations until a positive or a violation has been proved.
Fantastic, thank you for joining us on Sport Today. Now, I'm here at Conference Chelsea heading into the holiday fixtures. 6 points clear at the top of the Premier League table. They've won their past 11 matches, which of course was a new club record. History tells us at the top at Christmas, 9 times out of the last 12 tells us you will go on to win the league. So if the club's chasing Chelsea, can they catch them? Joining me on Sport Today is the Chief Football Writer of the Daily Mirror, John Cross, and sitting next to me is the BBC's Simon. First of all, I mean, we like our stats, don't we, as football fans and the people who follow the game. Do you think this is in the bag for Chelsea, or is one hand on the trophy?
Probably one anyway. It would put the team really short of confidence, and maybe that came back with that win over Arsenal. I think that if you win the big games, which they certainly do against Arsenal, and if they can do that against Liverpool, it would give me so much confidence, because I think the Guardiola's squad so far has been a little bit underperforming, whereas I think Liverpool, in contrast, have probably overexceeded expectations. For Liverpool to be in the title race, which I firmly believe they are, is a wonderful achievement for the Open Cup.
And the other side of Manchester, facing Sunderland, Man United, Jose Mourinho, what's the fact that he's been expressing his displeasure at the fixture congestion as he sees it for Man United?
Because if you analyse the sequel that I called for, there is no projection for them. It looks like because I've chosen to be a rest of fun and to create problems for others. But we are used to it because we are in the European Cup. The league is a competition that creates more difficulties.
So Simon, you were there. We know Mourinho likes to have little moans. What's the subject?
They are over 360 days in the year. Details like knives and swords or rime and snow all over the sky. They chase every day you are driven to this sport. When that day comes, when the spring comes to the end, flowers perish and we are old and tired. All returns to dust. In this world, no one will ever know our existence and no place to be.
Coming up is our usual bookstack segment. Today, our chance regarding the appointment of comic book character S. Conway and Bagger. Please stay tuned.
When to give up on paperback. One of the answers during our discussion about all the topics on Ink and Quill.
Hello, welcome to Good Chat. I'm Sue.
And joining her today is a new friend. Thank you for having me on the show again. I always look forward to these chats.
Wow, thank you, Jen. Well, the reason why I invited Jen to be on the show. Not so, I'm afraid. Winnie the Pooh, Tinker. There were all UN ambassadors in the cast. Their camera didn't last long as well, and it only worked when they lost their one day.
That kind of gets me the wrong way.
Mm-hmm.
I think that there's a lot of difference between Angry Birds and Wonder Woman in terms of what they stand for, but they seem to be categorized as the same entity.
So, like fictional.
Well, yeah, it's just basically cartoony fictional characters. Now, yeah. Angry Birds originally was based in a video game,
mm-hmm.
and they don't really have any key traits. It's literally about a bunch of birds that are angry and slingshot themselves at something. It's really that simple. But with Wonder Woman, she actually stands up for quite a lot. And when you look at the story of the main protagonist in her comic book, she's a woman who transcends throughout history. She's fought in many major battles. As we said earlier on in the show, she stands up for being courageous, for justice, and for doing what's right. Do you know the one thing I like about her more than any other superhero?
What?
With Superman, he has his laser X-ray vision, which can burn a hole in you. With Batman, he's got his throwing gadget, which can stab you. Wonder Woman's lasso, its special ability is that when she throws her harness around you,
you
have to tell the truth. And I think that says a lot about the kind of character and the kind of hero she is. She's someone who wants a lot of people are very disingenuous, regardless if it's related to economic relations, political relations, social relations, and so on. I think the concept of honesty as being an idol for the UN, there's a lot of merit to that.
You want to look at the